but this distracted driving summit is a wonderful thing. And I want to introduce the legislators we have up here, and I have Representative Friese here, and I'll let the legislators introduce themselves.
Thank you. Well, I'm Randy Friese, a representative from Tucson, Legislative District 9, which is sort of the northern Tucson lower foothills. I am in my second term, first year of my second term. And my day job, I'm actually a trauma surgeon, so I take care of patients that have been injured or hurt in motor vehicle collisions, bicycles, things like that. I work at the University Medical Center, now Banner, in Tucson.
And I am Senator Karen Fann from District 1, which is all the Prescott area up to Ashwark, over to Sligman, down to Wickenburg, coming across to Cave Creek, Carefree, Anthem, Desert Hills, Black Canyon City, and back up to Prescott, about 8,000 square miles.
I'm State Senator John Kavanagh, District 23, which is most of Scottsdale, all of Fountain Hills, Rio Verde, Tonto Verde, and the Fort McDowell Native American community. My full-time job is Professor of Criminal Justice, Scottsdale Community College, and I'm also a retired police officer. I retired in 93, back in New York, where when I was a cop, of course, the only distracted driving was pressing the buttons on your radio or slipping that A-track in.
And I'm Senator Steve Farley from District 9 in Tucson. My real job is I'm a public artist and graphic designer. I moonlight as a state senator. I was actually also the first legislator in the country to introduce a ban on driving while texting in January 2007, and I'm not giving up until I get one.
My name is Todd Clodfelter. I'm from District 10, which is basically East Tucson, Bear Down, Arizona. Sorry. I am a printer by trade, but I am now a state legislator, and I'm eager to assist with the process of getting a ban on handheld devices while you're driving your car. I live out on the east side, which is a lot of bicycle traffic up and down the road that goes up to Mount Lemmon. It's a good bike path for those guys who like to practice and train for the races. I don't ride a bike, but I do ride a motorcycle, so I feel almost as vulnerable as the guys on the bikes. And regardless of whether it's a bike, a motorcycle, or another automobile, we really got to take a look at this and see if we get this under control.
I'm going to start with Representative Clodfelter. Representative Clodfelter, what sort of ideas do you think the legislature can help with to help us with distracted driving?
Well, unfortunately, I think more laws is not really what we'd like to do. What we'd like to do is have people use their head and do things logically and not make mistakes like using the phone while they're, or a device while they're driving. But at the same time, I think we can create an awareness and come up with some concepts for some penalty for the people who are caught doing that and distracted, especially when they actually do cause an accident or cause personal injury. We already have laws that talk about distracted driving, but I think people, they don't realize that distracted driving means a lot of things. We really got to adjust with the concept of the new technologies that we have in hand. So I think that's what needs to be looked at. We need to create an awareness. We need to make sure that the penalties are accurate and proper for people who abuse that law.
Thank you. Senator Farley, as you indicated, you've been running texting bills for years and years. Why do you think it's so important that we get this sort of legislation passed?
Well, over the last 11 years, I have had countless victims' families come into my office and tell me the stories of what they and their families have gone through when a loved one has been killed or injured severely by a distracted driver. I don't want to see people come into my office and doing that again. Now, I don't believe that any law alone is going to be able to stop the problem. But we all have that cop in our heads that tells us whether or not we should do something. And the way to strengthen that cop is to make sure there is a law that unequivocally says, this is against the law, and if you do it, you're going to get busted. You got to approach that from a number of different perspectives. Number one, you need a statewide ban on use of an electronic device, reading or writing, visual or written messages, period. You need to make sure that applies to everyone, not just youth, because it doesn't matter how much experience you have, you can't do it. You just can't. You look at any of the studies, it's not possible to make that happen. So the ban is one thing. You need to get inside the head and strengthen that cop by actually putting penalties in place. One bill I actually came up with in brainstorming with former Senate President Andy Biggs, who was the one guy who got in the way of all this stuff, was to use it as an aggravating factor. So if you kill or injure somebody while using a phone and driving, you're going to do serious jail time. Just like if you use a gun in the commission of a crime, there's an increased sentence. That's one thing that needs to happen. We need to have it in the statutes that allows judges to revoke a license if somebody kills or injures somebody. And actually, Representative Clodfelter is running a bill to that effect to make that happen. And ultimately, we should be following the lead of the visionary people leading the town of Oro Valley and make it easier to enforce and make it clear to make sure you're following the law by simply outlawing any handheld use of an electronic device while driving, so that an officer can see if you got your phone in your hand, you are not in compliance. If it's down, you're fine. That's ultimately where we need to go. I'm not sure we're ready to go to that point yet in the state, but now that we have the main blockade not in the Senate anymore, but now in Congress, there's a possibility for people on all sides to be able to use their own conscience and vote for an outright statewide ban. Because this is beyond a partisan issue. The person that runs into you and kills you while they're distracted driving does not care if you're a Republican or a Democrat or an independent. They have no idea what you are. You're gonna get killed anyway. Everyone who has been affected by this is every party. It's all of us. We need to do this together, and we need to do it now.
Thank you, Senator Farley. Senator Kavanagh, you are sponsoring, I believe it's 1049, which is the texting ban this year. What sort of, do you look at this as a one solution, or do we have to go about this from multiple directions?
Well, my texting ban, well, first you have to understand, getting a texting bill through the Arizona legislature is a daunting task. Just based on two major factors. You see, we have different types of bills. We'll have some bills that are partisan, and the parties line up almost by designation on each on yes or no. We have bills that are controversial, but they're not partisan. So you have some Republicans and Democrats yes, some Republicans and Democrats no. We have some bills that everybody opposes, except the sponsor had one of those once. That was kind of embarrassing when you have those. But the problem with the texting bill is that you have opposition from both sides, but only a small number of members on both sides, but enough to pretty much kill the bill. You have, and the Republicans, you have our more libertarian-minded members who believe it's unnecessary government regulation, unnecessarily government infringement, and they'll say the current distracted driving laws, you know, are enough to do it, even though they obviously aren't. But you also have some Democrats, and I know this because I supported some of Senator Farley's earlier bills. I tried a bill myself earlier. You have some Democrats who vote against this because they believe that it will be an excuse for police pretext stops of minorities. So you peel off a few on this side, you peel off a few on that side, and the very tenuous majority you had dissipates. So you've got to educate people in those areas. You have to be incremental. You can't do it all at once, as obviously as we know. But you've got to deal with the opponents on both sides of the issue. It's hard to do. And obviously, if it wasn't hard, we'd already have the bill here. But that's the task, educating both sides and trying to bring people. And starting out, you know, without going for the whole enchilada, so to speak, in the beginning.
Senator Fann, you are also sponsoring a GDL bill, I believe, right now. And actually, I believe it successfully passed out of committee yesterday, 7-0. Why are you so passionate about the GDL laws and the distracted driving?
Thank you, and we couldn't have planned this better. Thank you for this, the great segue. Everything that Senator Kavanagh said, I say ditto, so let's go on to the next point. The bill that I have, this is the sixth year that I have run this bill, and I have every hope that it is going to be successful this year because some of my obstacles are no longer around. My bill has to do with the graduated driver's license, the Class G. These are the young people, the 16, 16 and a half year olds that have that Class G license before they get what I call an adult license. The reason why I believe this is a we call it, the Arizona Republic called it a baby step, so call it whatever you want, but at least it's a step in the right direction. The Class G license already has restrictions on it. You cannot drive with more than one minor in the car unless they're siblings. You can't drive after 10 o'clock unless you're going to or from work, and there's one or two other ones. The purpose of this is because we want these brand new drivers to concentrate on driving and learning to drive safely without distractions. So what my bill does is just adds one more restriction to it that says, and no, you cannot be using your cell phone and texting while you're driving, because you need to be learning how to drive. And the underlying part of it is that I'm hoping that not only do they end up being better drivers, but this will stick in their mind so that when they do get their adult license, then at that point they'll say, you know what, I know this is wrong. I should not be texting or using my phone while driving.
Thank you, Senator Fann. Representative Friese, maybe you're a medical doctor, so maybe you could give us some ideas, some background about how this, these kinds of accidents and so forth affect the victims, affect the people who are driving the vehicle, the running the vehicle, need to help.
That's a great question. Oh, yes, I'm not only a medical doctor, I'm a trauma critical care provider, so I take care of injured people. I meet them in the emergency room and continue their care throughout the hospital. And certainly I have seen the effects of someone who is injured by a distracted driver, and the effects of the injuries and how that changes their life through the recovery period, etc. But I've also seen and treated the drivers, the people who are distracted and commit this offense, and see how shocked they are of how quickly things happen and how quickly they take their eyes off the road for just a second or two, and the next thing they know someone's in front of them and they're hitting them with their vehicle. So I've seen the effects on these people's lives, how it changes their perception of, I could have avoided this if I had paid more attention. I could have avoided this if I had been more conscious of the fact that there's a law saying I shouldn't do this. So it's really an eye-opener when you see someone who has had one of these driving accidents. They are the person driving it and injure someone else, and the remorse and the shock and the sense of I could have prevented this. It's very apparent. So that's why this type of legislation, as Senator Farley was saying, should serve as a reminder. This is something you should not do, because you could unintentionally really, really hurt someone. And think about how that changes their life and how that changes your life. And that's why this is important.
Thank you, Representative Friese. I was handed a few questions that we were given by the audience, and I'm going to throw these out to open it to everybody to answer, maybe sort of limit your response to 2 or 3 minutes since we're short on time. But the first question I got was, and said, we understand the legislative body's challenges on their beliefs, but when there is an overwhelming majority of the public in support at 92%, why does the legislative body not listen to that 92%? And I'll start with Dr. Friese first.
Yeah, that's a great question. I think one of the issues is that there's a very vocal minority of people who are so passionate about certain issues that they will communicate with us very, very passionately and very, very regularly. That majority of people who agree with this type of legislation needs to step it up and get your voice heard and talk to your legislator, saying, you know what, that texting while driving bill is important, and this is why you should be supporting it. For an example, I just had a bill that was killed on motorcycle helmet use. And the reason was because there's a very vocal, very passionate minority who believes that they should have the right to choose to not wear a helmet. And what my colleagues heard was many, many messages from that vocal minority. What we didn't hear from was the majority who agree with that piece of legislation. They agree with that idea and that concept, but they weren't as engaged. They weren't passionate enough about it to reach out to their legislators. So what we need you to do, you are passionate, you're engaged. Get 5 or 6 of your friends and say, this is important. We need to communicate with them so they hear our voice. When we take polls and things, we see your majority, but we don't hear your voice. We need to hear your voice.
And And I would say Dr. Friese has some valid points. I'd like to also add on top of that, which is actually part of what Mr. Kavanaugh said, Senator Kavanaugh, is that there might be a number of us that fundamentally do agree with a policy, but part of that problem is trying to come up with the language for that bill. You've heard comments that were made already, and this is one of those bills that's very difficult to come up with language to make sure that you aren't discriminating, to make sure it's fair to all. One of my concerns has always been is making sure that, as I say, you're not guilty until proven innocent. If you were driving and an officer just thought that you were texting and you really weren't, and you get cited, are you guilty until you go get your records from the phone company and take it to court? So it's an important issue, but it's also very key that however this bill is written, that we make sure it's written properly without any unintended consequences.
Thank you. And I'm actually a doctor too, but I'm a PhD, which means phony doctor, so I can't treat any people. The reason why it's very difficult to get good bills like anti-texting legislation passed is because the people who wrote the Arizona Constitution followed the lead, the people who wrote the U.S. Constitution, and they made it extremely difficult to pass any bill. Because if it's not hard to pass bills, you'll see some really weird, wild stuff come out of Congress and the legislature. And even at the high hurdle we have now, you still get some weird bills coming out. But if the process is meant to make it hard to pass a bill, good bills unfortunately fall victim to the process. To get a bill out, it has to pass out of each committee it's assigned to in the Senate. It then goes to the full Senate, where it has to be approved by 16 senators. We then send it to the House. It gets assigned to the committees in the House. It must pass out of every committee it's assigned to in the House, and any committee chairman can refuse to hear a bill in its stead, so it's not even has to get voted out. And then it goes to the full House, where it has to pass out with 31 votes. Then it's got to go to the governor and not get vetoed. Unbelievably difficult hurdles, and that's why even good bills can't get out, because of the protections we have in the system. But you know what? Even though it stops good bills, you wouldn't want to have it easier, because the other stuff you'd see would scare you.
Well, I think the question is a good one, because 92% of Arizonans don't agree on mom or apple pie, much less anything political usually. So if they're coming together to say we need a ban on driving while texting statewide, that's significant, and we should be getting it done, because it's not as if we're an outlier on this issue. There are now 48 states that have some sort of statewide ban on driving while texting. I don't think we need more time to get the wording right. We've had 11 years. And over that 11 years, we've had more people fall victim to this practice. We gotta act, and we gotta act now. And I think it's up to you today to take that message to your individual legislators, make appointments in their offices, and deliver it directly to them and make it happen.
As Senator Farley identified, I am running a bill, and as are the other the senators, Dr. Friese, you got one going? No? Okay. Anyway, what it really takes is your input. If 92% of you and your friends and friends' friends who are in favor of this, like Senator Farley said, call in, send us an email, do whatever you got to do to let your desires be known, because we represent you. We represent the people of the state. I represent the people of my district, but technically I work for the state. I work for everybody. So the choices I make are the choices you want me to make. And we need to get things like this passed through because it's a no-brainer. Whether it's a bill that's got age restrictions on it or no restrictions on it, if it's you might think you're using a text or not doing a text, there's people being hurt daily, and we got to stop that. We've got to increase the mindset, as Senator Farley said, about the cop in the back of your head. You've got to know that it's wrong. You've got to encourage your friends that it's wrong. If you're driving with a spouse or a friend in the car and they pick up their phone, make them put it down, because that's part of our own policing. The laws will help, but if we police ourselves first, we can make that a lot easier and the transition much quicker. But call in, email, come in and talk to your legislators and support the bills that come out. You can find them online. You can see what's been dropped. The one I'm putting together has has not been dropped yet, but when it is, I would encourage you to look it up, read it, and then shoot your information into us so we can get back to you, or you can support it in committee.
Thank you, Representative Clodfelter. I've been handed multiple questions here, and I'm going to maybe direct them at each one to each of you and go from there. Representative Clodfelter, I'm coming back this direction. The question I was handed, citizens are asking for a hands-free distracted driving law. To get the right language, have you consulted with law enforcement experts around the state? They can assist. What can we do to get a hands-free texting bill passed in this state, or at least into the legislature?
Well, as it was pointed out, the law, once it's presented, has to go through committee. And if it's being heard in committee, the best thing to do is to show up to the committee meetings, go online, post your preference, because that's available online. If you want to get this particulars, call into my office or email me, and I'll shoot you back the links to get you signed up and in on that. Show up to the committee meetings and make your voice heard. That's primarily it. We have testimony from everybody who wants to testify, as long as time permits. And we have gone over time, plenty of times in committee meetings already this session, because we want to hear from the people who matter, who want things to matter. So again, check the bills that are being dropped. Find out when the committee meetings are. Send in emails. Show up to the committees. Testify. Police officers, police associations have already testified as to the value of a bill like this, and they can testify as to the damage it causes if it's not empowered. So testify. Come in. Let us know what you want.
Senator Farley, next question I was given. They wanted you to explain the deadline of February 17th to have bills out of the committee, and how can we get a statewide ban on texting onto the floor for a vote?
As a Democrat in the Republican legislature, there are many ways to work around the rules. That's sometimes the only tools we have available. I've had a lot of bills passed and signed by the governor, but they don't have my name at the top, because a lot of Democratic bills don't get heard, or they don't make it through the process. And when bills come through, even from Republican members that don't have necessarily the support of certain members within committees, as long as they don't also have the opposition of the president or the speaker, they can make their way through the process by getting permission of the sponsor, getting an amendment onto that bill, and then moving forward. There are a lot of different things that can happen for now. I think the key thing is that people want to have a statewide ban on driving while texting, or have a hands-free law or something along those lines, then the committee chair to which any of those bills have been assigned should be contacted and advocate that that bill should be heard. If the committee chair refuses to hear that, we look for bills that are moving, that are germane to the topic, and then try to approach the sponsor and find out ways that the sponsor will agree to have that bill amended onto the bill in order to move that forward. There are also, if it's from a Republican member to a Republican member, there's also something called a striker, which means that they have a bill that can be completely replaced by something relevant or irrelevant to the original subject, and then that can run through the process even after it's gone through a House or a Senate. So if you have two Republicans working on this to try and make it happen, anything can get done. Again, as long as you have the leader in the House or the Senate on your side to make that happen. There are a lot of different ways to make this work, and I think that it's going to take a lot of creativity, but if there is enough public outreach, if there's enough public outrage to try to be able to push for this type of thing, stop waiting any longer, then I think the pressure can be such that we can make it happen. That we are your representatives at base. If you make it clear that this is your issue, and we're going to be able to be reelected or not based on our position on this issue and how hard we work, we're going to respond. We do respond to our constituents, all of us. And everyone here wants to make it happen. They have different strategies for how to make it happen, but they all want to make it happen. And this is new. This is something where you have this many legislators all on the same stage together saying, we need to stop this practice. We just differ in our strategy. So if we can be here on this stage telling you this, we can get this thing done. I have no doubt we can. And I think ultimately my strategy, I believe, is that we should not be cautious. We can be cautious on one end, but let's put something through and just see what happens out there. because there's a lot more support from leadership on down in the conversations I've had than we have had in my 11 years here.
Thank you, Senator Farley. Senator Kavanaugh, I got another question. I think you've answered it, but maybe go into a little more detail. And it basically says, why is the Arizona legislature so adverse to passing bills banning texting and distracted driving?
Well, again, as I said before, you have some members who say that existing distracted driving laws are enough, which I know as a cop is not true. You have some members who just believe that it's government overreach, which I don't agree with. And you have some members on the other side who think that a primary texting ban will facilitate pretext stops by police for racial profiling purposes. You add all those little off here, little off here, little off there, and the very difficult magic numbers of 16 and 31 just totally disappear. I'll be frank, because, you know, I'm from New York, so we're frank in New York. Before the Arizona legislature passes a texting bill to the degree that I think most of us believe is needed, technology will solve the problem. And we're talking 10, 15 years from now. If you want to get a texting law passed the way we believe it should be passed, there's only one way you're going to do that, in my opinion, and that is a citizens initiative. That's the only way you're going to do it. You go around the legislature, you get your signatures, you put it on the ballot. And personally, if animal rights people could get gestation pig pages on an initiative and get passed, I don't know why all the different groups here can't do something like that.
Senator Fann, how do we go about, or what ideas do we use to better educate the public to distracted driving that the legislature can help with, or not even through the legislature, any other way?
Well, obviously, this event right here is wonderful. It's really amazing that all of our police public safety departments came out to support this. All of you guys are here. Continue doing these things in your local neighborhoods, in your local communities. I know many of you are from all different parts of the state here, just like, you know, the Mothers Against Drunk Drivers. That's how they finally got their voices heard, is not only did they do it on a national level, but they started these grassroots groups from all different communities and started chapters, and that's how that finally got done. I think the other thing is that we keep hammering on the radio, television ads, kids do that. YouTube, I mean, everybody's YouTube in these days, Facebooking. So I think that the more we get the word out, besides trying to do some legislation, because people still do stupid things even when laws are in place, it is a matter of just keeping that out there and making everybody understand the ramifications of what can happen.
Thank you, Senator Fann. Representative Friese, we got a question about the federal government and should they be doing something to step in and denying funds to the states to stop texting and distracted driving? What sort of thoughts do you have on that?
Well, I mean, that's an interesting avenue. You know, I'm not sure that's the best avenue. You know, Arizona is a really, really careful about states' rights and not limiting them, what we do based on what the federal government does. And in fact, I'm bringing it back to motorcycle helmets. And back in the 60s and 70s, federal dollars were tied to universal helmet laws. That went away because, you know, it just wasn't a great, it worked in, as far as getting them people to wear their helmets, but as soon as those federal dollars went away, the helmet laws started to drop as well. So it's been shown to work, but I don't know if it's going to be accepted well here. It would certainly need resistance. We've got to come up with a solution within our own culture and within our own belief sets and within our own, you know, the way we think of ourselves as a state. I just want to comment real quickly, and I hope Brenda doesn't mind me sharing a story about what Senator Fann was saying about how can we do this. Education is part of it. And sharing a story like Brenda's is so important, because I was talking about the person, not only is the victim somebody that we have to hear from, hear how it affects their lives, we have to hear from the driver. And Brendan actually met the young man that injured him, was able to forgive him, and developed a bit of a friendship. And I think that's a story that if we could put it on YouTube, or we could get public service people to say, look, and get the young man who injured Brendan's story, and how they have developed this friendship, it will touch your heart and will make you think twice about, you know, driving distracted, particularly texting. So I think that's an important story. Ask him. It's a great story.
Thank you, Representative Friese. I'm going to basically throw this out to everybody here. We've heard the police were up here saying we needed distracted, hands-free laws. They can't enforce a texting ban. And it's impossible for them to do it. I'm just curious, what other legislative initiatives do you think we should be looking at besides just an all texting ban? And I'll start in the middle, I guess, with Senator Farley.
As long as I got the mic in my hand, thank you. Because I did want to mention another bill we haven't talked about, which I've worked on really hard for the last couple of years with Brendan Lyons and Damian Alexander, the bicycle community in particular, along with the disabled community, construction workers, law enforcement. It's called the Vulnerable User Bill. This is modeled on legislation that turned into a law in Florida. Because currently, if somebody tries to force you off the road or throw a full beer bottle at you, it's not a crime. We need to make those types of activities a crime. We need to protect those people who use the roadways on the side of the roadways but don't have a hunk of metal to protect them. So that's people on tractors, construction workers, first responders. It's bicyclists, it's pedestrians, it's disabled people. Those people need protections as well. We've had too many incidences of these types of assaults happening without being charged. We need to make sure that people who are on the roadways but don't have protections get those protections to be able to provide them in the law. So that's an important one in my book as well.
Senator Kavanaugh, you want to pop in?
Beyond laws, I suspect the biggest inroads will be made in promoting safety from texting and telephone calls will be technology. Technology in the cars where, you know, it's totally hand-free, where the text images will be projected on your driver's windshield so you don't have to look away, where cars already have special anti-automatic braking systems, where if a person is getting too close to the car in front of them, as an emergency, the car automatically brakes. I think, other than legislation, that's pushing those thoughts of laws for that kind of technology is probably the most productive way. It's kind of hard for a state to mandate auto standards, so that would have to be something at the federal level. Although certainly at the state level, we might, by encouraging insurance companies to give discounts to people who have these things and pay for them on their new cars, that could promote it. We might even be able to give some sort of tax credits or rebates for all or part of the expense of some of this equipment when people buy new cars. But outside of legislation, the other thing is technology, which I think has a lot of promise to help also.
Thank you, Senator Kavanaugh. So we are running short on time, so we're going to sort of wrap it up here. And if anybody wants to make the last few comments, Senator Fann, if you want to pop in with these last few comments.
Just want to say thank you all very much for coming down. Appreciate you being here.
Anybody else? We want to thank you all for coming out here today, and we want to especially thank the organizers for putting this on. This has been wonderful. We want to thank the representatives for coming out and talking to us. Thank you.